revealing you the secrets of delicious butter-drenched escargot. I will for sure show you the classic techniques, but also I will take you on a more modern journey. So let's do it. My name is Romain Avril, aka Frenchy Cooks, and this is the secrets of French cuisine with fine dining lovers. When it comes to escargot, it's really what you serve with them. They are such a vehicle for flavor. Traditionally, we would serve them with garlic butter, but I also want to get creative. So for our second dish, I will actually pair it with some braised beef cheeks, and trust me, you'll be stunned with the results. All right, for our first dish, I'm going to start with making the garlic butter. I'm simply going to mix some garlic, parsley, and butter together to form a delicious and flavorful paste. So I'm adding the butter. I am then gonna grab some garlic. Obviously, we wanna be very generous when it comes to the garlic. It is a garlic butter. I will then grab the parsley. I'm going to just chop it very roughly. I will then add some black pepper. And we're obviously gonna add some salt. I am now going to blitz the mix until it forms a smooth paste, roughly about 4 to 5 minutes. All right, our butter is combined. I'm just gonna give it a taste to make sure I'm happy with the salt. Perfect. I'm now gonna transfer it from the machine to a piping bag. Just gonna push the mix. All right, so let's work on the stuffing of the shells. This reminds me of Christmas dinner back home when I was a child. I always loved escargot. Some people spend so much time taking them out of the shell, and now I'm just putting them back in. All right, so we're gonna start piping the butter onto the escargot. The little tips when you actually use a piping bag is to pinch it like you would hold a pen, and you're gonna wrap the top around your finger, and you're gonna twist it. So that way, you can actually keep pushing the mix. Every time you're done, you're gonna rotate. And then I'm going to stuff my escargot with a generous amount of butter. I will now bake them at 375 for about 5 to 10 minutes, or until the butter is nice and foamy. All right, well, now it's time to enjoy it. So I have some French bread, which I'm just going to break open. And we're gonna use this little contraption that we have classically in France. You would take the little pinch to grab the snail, just like so. And then we're gonna grab the escargot with a little fork, and then we go for it. Mm. And my little secret is actually to get all the butter. Mm. That's not good for your arteries, but trust me, it's really good for your palate. And you see all this butter that you're wasting? I actually like to take my bread and to soak all that good butter. And that goes for the best treats. That is just next level. The garlic, the butter, the parsley, it is so rich and so delicious and so simple. That is the classic way to do it. But today we're gonna take this brasserie dish to a Michelin star restaurant. All right, so first we're gonna serve with a kohlrabi. I will make two applications with the kohlrabi. The first one, we're gonna turn it into little batons that I will glaze with some fish stock and aromatics. Because we don't like wasting, I will cook the trims with some cream and some milk and some aromatics, and we'll turn that into a luscious and delicious puree. All right, so let's start with the kohlrabi. I'm going to start to trim the bottom as little as possible and some of the top. And then we're gonna peel it off. Now that we peeled off our beautiful vegetable, we're gonna actually create some batons. So I'm gonna go right closer to the center. Detail two slices. And then we're gonna make some beautiful batons. All For the glazing, I'm going to place the batons into the pot and I'm going to cover it with a bit of fish stock, about 2/3 of the way. I will then add a bit of olive oil, some butter, and we're going to add some aromatics. I'm going to use a bit of thyme, a clove of garlic, just mashed, a shallot, a couple of lemon peels. I'm just going to add a bit of salt, and we're going to cook that with a cartouche. So what is a cartouche, you ask? It's actually something I'm going to put over top. So I'm using some parchment paper that I turn into a paper plane, and I'm going to cut it to size. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to place it over top. Now that I have the center, I see that I got to cut it about right here, which I will do so. And I will also cut the tip, which will allow air to be extracted. Then we're going to unfold it. Now you have a perfect circle with a tiny hole in the center. You can see me still. And we're going to place it over top the pot. And as you can see, it fits perfectly. So that way it will allow to cook while releasing some steam as well. And I'm going to cook it until softened, which is probably about 6 minutes. So for the puree, I'm going to start by dicing all the trimmings that we didn't use. The idea is to cut them small so it goes faster. We are now going to place a kohlrabi inside of the pot. I will then cover the kohlrabi with milk and cream. And I'm now going to add my aromatics. So a bit of thyme, some shallots, and some garlic. I'm going to smash a clove, chop it finely, and we'll add that to our mixture. A bit of salt. And we're going to cook it for about 20 minutes or until softened. All right, so we have our baton cooking. Our puree is also cooking on the stove, which is giving me some time to work on the mustard jelly. All right, so first I'm going to pour my fish stock. I am then going to add my mustard, about a tablespoon, and my agar-agar. So for ratios, agar-agar for a set jelly is about 0.9 gram per 100 milliliters. The one thing with an agar jelly, you want to actually set it, but you have to cook it first to activate the agar. And then we're going to give it a tiny whisk. I mean, literally, a tiny whisk. So now that my jelly has come to a boil and cooked for about 2 minutes, I'm going to pour it into my pan. And we're gonna set it in the fridge for about 20 to 25 minutes. All right, so our jelly is now set. I already went ahead and detailed it into baton. All we gotta do now is just to cube it. It's just for presentation's sake. You could actually do any shape or form that you would want. All right, another secret of the recipe is the braised beef cheeks. I cooked them yesterday for about 3 hours. They braised in some delicious aromatics with some red wine. And I'm going to use this to accompany the escargot. We're gonna add that braising liquid and it's gonna really enrich the escargot. So that's another little secret. So our braised beef cheeks are ready. We have a mustard jelly. Our batons are ready and cooked. All we gotta do now is to finish the puree. So I'm gonna take all of my kohlrabi and I'm gonna place it into my mixer and we're gonna blitz it with some of the cream, not all of it. We can add as we see fit and get a beautiful smooth texture. Alright, let's have a look at the puree. It looks beautiful, luscious. I'm gonna give it a try. And there's a bit of seasoning, which I will add in a second. And we're gonna transfer it into a pot. Just gonna add a bit of seasoning to the puree. Now I'm really happy with it. We can start saute the escargot and then we'll plate. So I'm gonna heat my pan, add just a tablespoon of canola oil and some butter. The canola is just so I don't burn my butter. And we're gonna let that foam. All right, the butter is foaming, so I'm going to add the escargot. We're not trying to cook them. We just wanna warm them up and glaze them. I will also add some seasoning and a bit of black pepper. I'm gonna hit it with a bit of thyme and just a bit of lemon, and we're now going to flambe it with the Pernod. Make sure the pan is nice and hot. Watch your eyebrows. It's gonna give that beautiful anise taste, which is actually one of my favorites. All right, now that we've burnt off the alcohol, I'm gonna add the braised beef cheeks. And then I'm gonna add the braising liquid. And we're gonna let that reduce for about 2 to 3 minutes. After a few minutes, I'm going to actually remove the thyme and the lemon peel, because if you leave it for too long, it could give it a bit of a bitter taste. All right, so now that we've reduced our braising liquid, it's almost syrupy, we are about ready to be plating. And here we have it, some delicious escargot with some braised beef cheeks, kohlrabi, and mustard jelly, finished with a bit of lemon balm. I cannot wait to try it, so if you allow me, I'm going to dig in. Listen, as much as I love the classic, this one is just way more out there. You have so many flavor combinations. The richness from the beef cheeks with the escargot, the texture, the smoothness and sweetness from the puree, and the mustard jelly give it a little kick, and everything is lifted with the herbs. I highly recommend this dish to you. It's going to change your life. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please make sure to watch the other episodes where we'll be teaching you the secrets of French cuisine with a modern twist. Don't forget to subscribe to Fine Dining Lovers and share your creation at #FineDiningLovers. You can also check me out on Instagram at Chef Romain Avril and on YouTube as Romain Avril. I will see you soon.